death made a way where there was no way. Father God, that you never fail us. Amen.
Will
hallelujah. We're here just to bless the name
you
of the Lord.
Never fail me, yeah. And I never will forget.
We never will forget, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, church, for coming in this hour. Amen. And blessing the name of the Lord with me. You know, as I was doing some things here today, amen, I come across a very big word, and I'm sure sometimes that can be very hard on these difficult words that we have to consume within our lives, because those are the type of words that we have to allow them to take a part of our lives so that we can obtain the word, the knowledge, and all these things that God has set us up. You know, we got to know that God has set us up for accomplishment. God has set us up for the goodness of God. God has set us up even in the challenging times. You know, even the times of sickness and the times of your health, your wealth, you know, that has to deal with our finances and all these different spectrums and areas. Even though we're being challenged, we must work our faith and getting into the things that God has spoken into our lives. And that's what we're doing here today. Amen. As I was getting into the word, we will go ahead and pray. Amen. I'm just going to give you a little bit of aspects on some of the things. And I'm going to reveal that word. Believe me, I will reveal that word. But let us go ahead and pray and just ask God here divinely for the exactness of what he's speaking in our hearts and in our lives here today. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Amen. Thank you for all those that are coming on in, those that will be seeing us in a different time, a different space, a different place, and all those that are connecting with us even through our worldwide streaming radio, through iHeartRadio, through Google Podcasting, through Spotify. There's just so many areas, so let's go ahead and get into this word. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the word of God, the promising of your word, where your word speaks yes and amen, and where we are highly favored, Lord, and that you are showing us the very aspects of our lives and what you're wanting to work as our hearts are open and receptive in receiving that which you have for us, continually to make a way, even where there seems to be no way, you will complete that promise within our lives as we honor you and we bless your name. For you know our hearts and our lives coming in and going out, that even in the hard places, the tough places, Lord, that we will stick to the plan, your plan, the heaven's purpose, and that designation of what the Lord wants to do in our lives. Places and spaces. Hey, it could be the automobiles. Come on now. It could be all in all where God is speaking. Amen. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. So the big word that I'm speaking here even today, amen, it may be your night, it may be your morning, hey, it may be your mid-morning, amen. And the word over our life here today is discipleship, amen, discipling and discipleship, amen. We as the discipler and receiving the disciple, we have to know who are we feeding off from and of. You know, sometimes when I love to go out to eat, of course, there's just so many things that I love to eat. And if I'm specific about a certain food and you get the other plate that I enjoy as well, sometimes I just want to, you know, pick off your plate, you know, just that little, I just want that little bit and I'll be good. I don't need the whole plate. I have my own plate. And me and my husband would always laugh about that all the time because, you know, he just said that they're just people all throughout his time that always said, let me just have that little, you know, that little plate off of my plate. And it just always seems that because he always leaves, like, always a little portion off and on the plate. And that's something that in my house, it was like, no, what you serve, that's what you're going to eat. And you got to remember, you know, maybe all this, there's kids in Africa that are hungry, you know. So everything, that chicken on that bone, it just all had to be clean. I don't know who's in the house. Maybe you had to be that way as well. Amen. I'm not too sure. But I'm just saying, and maybe that's the reason why we've got extended hands all the way to Africa to be feeding the kids in Africa. Come on now. And the orphanage home and all these different things where we are actually being the hands and feet of Jesus, giving honor and glory to God. Once again, the big word is discipleship. And so just like what we know, what we're absorbing, what we're receiving, even what we're exuding, we have to know who we're receiving from. Is that person themselves being discipled? Are they being nurtured? Are they being encouraged? You know, we have so many ways, so many spectrums through the Word of God, through the social media platforms, through those that we see that are well known around the world. You know, what are we feeding off of in and for our discipleship? Now, I know you can go to a buffet and you can get this and this and this and this and this and this and that, you know, and add a little this and add a little that. And you know, you just have a whole spectrum. But there's always going to be that one channel. There's always going to be that one way. There's always going to be that specific that's going to be precisely in what you're needing in your life. And that's where the word comes in. And discipleship. You know, if you haven't been drossed with something, how is it that you can give out something? You see what I'm saying? I just said a word there. Because we have to know that when we're being receiving something, that we're able to give out that something just the same. And so discipleship is allowing the Lord to disciple us in many areas, in our walk, in our talk, in our character, in our speaking, our speech, our reading. And maybe it's even something that you have actually channeled in and throughout even your day on a process. Now, my mornings are the week, early mornings of the night, even the early mornings of the morning. It might be through prayer. It might be the reading of the word. Of course, it's these two things, you know, because you can't really do one without the other. Amen. But when you get into something, you really allow it to speak to your life. Let it come alive into your life and saying, this is what the Lord is doing. I'm discipling you. And so you have to see that being in God's word is, you're being discipled in and through God's word. Physically, I understand you want the pinching of the person. You want the grabbing, the holding of the person. Like you feel, okay, this is all this is needed. But we have to know without a shadow of doubt that Jesus is our discipler. The word is saying here at Matthew 10, 37 and 39. And that should be our prayer. Lord, disciple me. That anyone who loves his father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. You know, and that's pretty big right there. Amen. Because we can't love any other more than what we love God. It's not worthy of me. Anyone who loves his son or his daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And anyone who does not take his cross and follow me, come on now, is not worthy of me. We have to pick up our cross, follow after the Lord to be worthy. This is God's standard. This is not even Tina Viesca's standard. This is God's standard through his word out of Matthew chapter 10, verses 37 and 39. Because whoever, as the word says, whoever finds his life will lose his life. And whoever loses his life for my sake will actually find it. And so the more that we get into God, into his presence, into his discipling, you may feel like you're losing your life because, you know what, you're not going here, you're not going there, I'm not able to do this, I'm not able to do that. But God is saying, no, that's when truly you will find the life in which I have for you. This is God discipling us within our lives. And so that's where we truly see and know that do we really love Christ enough to pick up his cross and follow me. Follow in the Lord. Amen. Let me make that clear. That doing any of that more than him, we are not worthy. That's Bible. And Luke chapter 14, verse 33, any of you who does not give up anything that he has cannot be my disciple. So we see we have to be in an area of giving. Giving up everything has not, he cannot be my disciple if we give not up everything. So in order to obtain something, we have to be able to give up something, then to receive something. That's also to the same format that whoever loses his life for the sake of God will actually obtain the life in Christ. Hello? In Psalms 15, 1 through 2, the word reads, Lord, who may dwell in your sanctuary? Who may live on your holy hill? That it is he who walks is blameless, and who does what is righteous, and who speaks the truth.